Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel, Jennifer Marie, where I talk to you about different ways to make money online as a work from home freelancer. Today I'm excited to talk to you about three free AI tools in Canva using Magic Studio, and you do not need a pro account to use these tools. You can use these tools for content creation to make videos, social media content, any graphic design needs, and so much more. I'm going to go through each tool, but the first tool we're going to go through is Canva's text-to-image tool. In order to use this tool, you will need to sign up to Canva. Again, it's free to use this tool. If you don't already have a Canva account, you can sign up for free using my link in the description below. So I actually used this tool to create this background image, and I used this background image for my thumbnail for this video. All I did was type in a little text prompt and it created this image for me. You can create background images or wallpaper. Let's say you want to create some cool, spooky Halloween backgrounds for your social media content or even your YouTube thumbnails like I did. Or let's say you're a teacher and you're writing a little story. You can use the watercolor prompt and make some cute little fall imagery to go along with your story or with your worksheet. Or let's say you're creating a YouTube video and you want some cartoons that you can use. Canva generated everything on this page and it did so instantly. So I'm going to show you how to use this tool and then quickly how we can incorporate it if you want to make some social media content. You can look at the chapters in this video if you want to skip to the next two AI tools. So there are two ways to access the first AI tool. You can click here on Magic Studio on the side. And this will show you all of the different AI tools that Canva is now offering. Now, a lot of these you can only access with the Pro account. And again, in this video, I'm focusing on the free tools. So if you scroll to the bottom, you can click on Text to Image, then click Try It Out. So here you can see the Magic Media tab is open. So in this box here, we just have to describe the image we want and Canva will generate it for us. Three children in Halloween costumes going trick or treating. You can also select any style you want. Let's click see all, and you can see they have introduced even more styles than the last time I talked about this tool. Let's click playful. Then you could choose the aspect ratio, so square, landscape, or portrait. We're going to stick with square for this, and then you can click create your image. So you can see here that this will use one of 40 credits if you do not have the Pro account. I have the Pro account, but I'm doing this demo with a free account just so you can see that you can actually use this tool. Then click create your image. And look at these adorable images it's created. I just love them. This looks like something straight out of a storybook. You can see it's created four images in total. This is the first one. You can click here, add page, and add all of the images to each page. And that way you can get a glimpse of all of them. You can see some aren't perfect, this one for example, but a lot of them are really great. And say you don't like a part of an image, you could even cut it out and just use the pumpkin or just use the bats or use elements of it. Or if you have any knowledge of photo editing, make some changes. But for social media content, these are just perfect because they don't have to be flawless. So make sure to save these by clicking share and download and downloading them as a PNG. If you download all of them, it will download it as a zip file and just click download, because if you click off, you will lose these images. So you can experiment with different styles. We can even use the same prompt. Why don't we try concept art this time and see what that comes up with and click generate again. And check out these ones. These are just unreal. Of course, if you know how to do some editing and can change the faces up a little bit, that would be even better. But look how cool these are. So again, remember to save all of these and then you can use them in your other projects. So now let's do a quick demo of how we can use these in one of our projects. So let's go back to Canva and let's say you want to create an Instagram post for your business or something like that. Let's click on Instagram post. Let's say I have a lifestyle blog and I want to create some social media content. I'm going to type in tips right at this search bar here, and then just find a template you like. Any of the images that have the Pro icon are for people who have the Canva Pro account. So otherwise search for a template that is free to use. So I've gone with this hair care tips template, and I'm going to do a Halloween safety tips for my lifestyle blog. Then upload the image you want to make your background. I'm going to go with this one here. just drag and drop it, and that will make it your background. Now just type in your own information. You can add an outline to the text or change the text type. Let's say I want to change these circles so it matches the color scheme of my image. Click on the circle, then click on color, and you only have to change one, and then click change all, and it will change the rest of them. And now I have an awesome, unique image that I can post on my social media. It's important to post unique images on social media because a lot of people use Canva. So even though we want to use templates from Canva, if everyone uses the same Halloween template, you won't be creating unique content. Doing something like this allows you to be more creative and have unique content. So the next AI tool I'm going to show you that you can use in Canva is they have a text to video feature. So if you put in these prompts, you can create all these creepy, spooky little videos or whatever kind of video you want. Because of this season, I'm focusing on Halloween. For this video, for example, I put in Halloween Town conceptual art. This one, I put monsters walking down the street during Halloween. And it only creates these little 4-second videos, but these are perfect for reels or shorts. So if you look on YouTube and you search quiz or Halloween quiz or would you rather, you can see there are lots of these types of videos. Would you rather walk through a graveyard at night or an abandoned house? We can create videos like these using the text-to-video software I'm going to show you. So once again, open up Canva, and this time let's type in Instagram reel. So if you don't have a pro account, I want you to click here on all filters. And you can select to only look for free templates, then click apply. So I've gone ahead and picked this template here. Now this template right now is just an image, but we can turn it into a video really quickly. All we have to do is click on the background, then click animate. And here you can choose any of the animations that you like. I'm gonna go with the disco one. You can also change the length. So let's make this maybe around 10 seconds. And I just want to show you a really quick demo. So we're going to turn this into a Halloween reel. Let's write which monster is scarier. Then we'll change the font to Jeepers. And we can change these blocks to give it a more Halloween vibe. So now we're ready to add our AI generated videos. You're going to go to the side and click on Magic Media. So we already use the image tool, but now we're going to use the videos tool. Now, one thing that's important is that with the free plan, you can generate 4 different videos. With the pro plan, you can generate 41 videos each month. I've logged into my pro account right now because I've been experimenting with a few different videos. So you're going to describe a scene to generate a few seconds of video. I'm going to put a scary Halloween vampire, comma, conceptual art. Let's see what that generates and click generate video. So this is powered by Runway. So it will take around a minute or so to generate. And this is what it's come up with. This is so weird and creepy and I love it. I think these AI videos are perfect for Halloween or for anything kind of weird and different and fantasy. So an easy way to save this is just right click, save video as, and that will save it as an MP4 file directly on your computer. So you don't have to go share and download it that way. So if we click on the video, we can watch it up close. You can see it's really weird and creepy. So this is something that would be perfect for a little reel. So I'm going to add this to our video here on Canva. Just click and drag and drop it into this frame. So now to reposition it within this frame, double click, and we can just go like that. And look how weird and creepy he is. I love it. So you can click generate again. I'm going to click go back and try a different video, a Walking Dead style zombie Halloween conceptual art. Again, generate video. You can see it's come up with this guy who's even creepier than the last one. So I'm going to click drag and drop again, click reposition. Can even go like this to make it even bigger. There we go, done. So now we can preview our video. And this is a perfect little reel. Now this only lasts for 4 seconds. We want to make it last a bit longer. If to click here on the show pages icon, then click playback. We're actually going to decrease the speed for this and enable play on repeat. And I'm just going to go like that. And this now the videos are a little bit slower and it lasts for 8 seconds. So to download your video, download, and then download it as an MP4 video. And it will be in the perfect format for your Instagram reel, TikTok, YouTube, or whatever. And now that you have this template created, you could go ahead and generate other little videos with different monsters and do a series of this or that. All you would have to do is drag and drop them. And if you have the free plan and you've run out of credits, you can click on the Photos tab here, type in Halloween monsters, for example, click on this filter icon, filter by free, and then you can just use something like this if you want and drag and drop it as well. And it will still be animated. And actually, a great thing about the pictures is because they aren't videos, you can extend the length like this and make it as long as you want. So this is just another alternative if you have the free plan and you still want to create a lot of content. I also created this other video as a demo on Canva, and I used the text-to-video software to create this spooky little background. You can add multiple pages and make the video a little bit more dynamic. If you're interested in a full tutorial on making something like this, let me know in the comment section below. You can see in this one, it says, would you rather spend Halloween with this witch or your ex-girlfriend or boyfriend? And then I write comment below. And something like this entices people to comment, oh, I'd much rather spend Halloween with that witch than with my boyfriend. It's just sort of a way to get people to engage. You can also add music easily to these videos by clicking on elements and then click up here where it says search elements and click on audio. You could type in Halloween and then go and find one that doesn't have the pro icon and just click to add the audio. You can see I've already added audio, but if I hadn't, I would just drag it and reposition it wherever I wanted the audio to start and stop. Click audio effects and you can add a fade in or a fade out. Again, if you want a full tutorial on how to create something like this, let me know in the comment section. And finally, I'm going to show you how to use the Magic Edit tool. So for example, here's my original photo, and I want to use this in my thumbnail. So I've used the Magic Edit tool to transform it into this image here, which is a great image I could use on social media or in my YouTube thumbnail. You can see that the cutout of myself I've used for the thumbnail of this video. And with Magic Edit, you work in pieces. So first, I added a hat. Then I changed the background, then I changed my clothes. We can also use this tool to change elements in the background. So I removed the apartment buildings and added this nice mountain and castle. And we're going to do a demo with this picture now. So open up the image you want to edit in Canva, then click on the image and click Edit Photo. Now under Magic Studio, click Magic Edit. So now you just have to brush over the part of the image you want to change. So here's a picture of me from last weekend. I went away for my birthday and I found this statue of Prince Charming. So let's say I want to make it a bit more majestic. I want to erase these apartment buildings and add some mountains or a castle or something like that. So just use the brush tool to brush over the area you want to edit. So I'm just going to brush over all the sky and you can zoom up and change the brush size to make sure you get all the parts that you want to edit. And you can go over here. So once you're finished, click continue. Now you have to describe your edit. So describe what you want to add or change. I'm just going to write mountains and clouds. Now, Magic Edit is not intended for editing faces, hands, or legs. So if you want to change your outfit or your hairstyle, try to avoid brushing over your face and just stick to the hair or to the clothing, but not the hands or the legs because it might turn out a little wonky. Then click Generate. So you can see it's come up with 4 different results. So you can click on any of the squares to view the results that it's come up with. And you can use the Magic Edit tool again and again and add more elements. I recommend doing it in pieces. Let's say you want a castle. First, ask for your landscape. and then use the tool again to ask for a castle rather than asking for everything all at once. You'll get a better result that way. And you can experiment with all sorts of different backgrounds. Here I asked for a castle and a rainbow. Some of them are a little strange, but then some ended up being really nice. This one, for example, I think looks great. And then you can download this picture or you can search for a template in Canva and add your image. So you can see I made this cool little Instagram post, Prince Charming is worth the wait. Imagine I have a lifestyle blog or a relationship blog or something like that. So these AI tools are awesome. They're so easy to use and they're all available to you on Canva. And once again, if you don't have a Canva account, make sure to click on my link to sign up. Right now, Canva is also offering a 30-day free trial if you want to try out some of the other pro AI tools. And you can check out my playlist of other AI tools in the description below. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in my next tutorial.